بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ستودنتس، ويلكم تو باكستان سكول مسقطي ليرنينج، اند وي ار ليرنينج فروم اور بوك اميزنج ساينس جريد 4، اند ايم يور تيوتر مس دردزا. ويلكم تو ذا ساينس كلاس ستودنتس. ار يو ريدي تو ريفيو يونت نمبر 5؟ دونت فورجيت ذا رولز، ات ويل هيلپ يو تو فوكس اون وات وي ار ليرنينج. يونت نمبر 5، ماتر اند اتس ستيتس. Today's plan will review some important parts of the lesson from book pages number 42 to 48. We'll discuss and explain some important part. After that, recap and then quiz. So let's get started, students. Brainstorming. What is ventilation? Students, the coming in of fresh air and escaping of warm, stale air is called ventilation. Matter. Students, anything that has weight and takes up space is called matter. There are many different kinds of things in the world. They are of different shapes, types. Some are hard, some are soft, some are warm, and some are cold. Some may be wet or dry. All these things look and feel different from each other. All things in the world have weight and takes up space. Anything that takes up space and has weight is called matter. Matter is made up of very tiny particles called atoms. There are millions and millions of atoms in a tiny grain of sand. States of matter. Matter can be found in three forms or states. The state of matter depends on the arrangement of its particles and also on the amount of space between them. Matter can be in solid form or in a liquid form or in the form of a gas. A rock is a solid, water is a liquid, and oxygen is a gas. Solids. In a solid, the particles are close together. They are linked to each other and are arranged regularly. Therefore, a solid has fixed shape and fixed volume. Liquid. In a liquid, the particles are close together, but they can slide over one another. Within a certain limit. Therefore, a liquid has no fixed shape, but it does have fixed volume. Gases. There are the bigger spaces between the particles in a gas than between those in liquid. They are not linked and can move freely in all the directions. For this reason, a gas has no fixed shape and no fixed volume. Matter can change its state. Students, substances remain solid, liquid, or gas at a certain temperature. If they are heated or cooled, they can change form. For example, when ice is solid, is heated, it changes to water, a liquid. When water is heated, it changes to water vapor, a gas. How a change of state occurs? Heating makes the particles in a substance move faster and knock each other farther apart. As they begin to move around freely, a change of state occurs. For example, when solids such as ice is heated, its particles begin to move faster. Eventually, they move so fast that they move away from each other. As they begin to move around more freely, the ice melts. It changes to liquid water and no longer has a fixed shape. Changes of state occurs 5 different processes in which melting. If you heat a solid, the particles begin to move faster, so they have a lot of energy. They hit against each other and begin to move apart. When this happens, the solid melts into a liquid. The temperature which solid changes into liquid is called melting point. So what is freezing? When a water is put in a freezer, it cools down. The particles lose energy and they slow down. They move closer to each other and the liquid freezes to become a solid. The freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. Boiling. When a water is heated, bubbles appear on its surface as it begins to boil. The temperature at which liquids start boiling is a boiling point. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Evaporation. Liquid water changes into gas vapor. This can happen even without boiling. So what you can do that if you can leave some water in an uncovered pan, it slowly changes into water vapor. Finally, the pan becomes dry. This change of liquid to a gas is called evaporation. Now condensation. Put some ice cube in a glass. You will see that the droplets of water form on the outside of the glass. This happens because water vapor in the air changes into water droplets. So, when it touches a cold surface, this change of vapor or gas into liquid is called condensation. Okay? So, now we ask, these are quiz time, students. I have so matched the following columns. I hope that you already read or reviewed unit number 4 as well. So the temperature at which liquid changes into solid, it's a freezing point. Temperature at which solid changes into liquid is melting point. The temperature at which liquid boils is a boiling point. The temperature, the change of state from liquid to gas is evaporation. And the pine trees have needle-like leaves. Now we are comes to next. Our next topic is about mixtures. Mixture contain more than one substance. It is not a pure substance. Air is a mixture of many gases. Coffee is a mixture of water, sugar, and coffee beans. Even so many drinks you are drinking, and there is a different kinds of a mixture they are mixed with, means that, for example, if you are making some kind of a sherbet, so you need sugar, water, and the liquid sherbet, the liquid drink, which is mixed with water to make a solution of a juice. Maybe it will say ruafza, maybe it is a tang juice. So that is a solution actually. So when a mix, when we mix sugar and water, means one solid and one liquid. See, you can see after some time when you are stirring, there is no remains. Sugar completely dissolves in water. So that is a solution. Some substances are not soluble in water. Okay, so we say that they are insoluble. They do not dissolve in water. For example, chalk in water, sand in water. Okay. Now emulsion, if we are mixing two liquids together, that kind of a liquid which cannot mix together, like oil and water. So that kind of a liquid which we cannot mix properly, that is emulsion. And when we have a mixture of two different solids, means metals. So when we mix two metals together, that is called an alloy. For example, bronze is an alloy of metal, copper, and tin. Students, method of separating mixtures. Evaporation method. Students, evaporation is a technique used to separate out homogeneous mixture that contain one or more dissolved salts. The method derives of the liquid components from the solid components. The process typically involves heating. Heating the mixture make all the water evaporate
and salt residue left behind. So what we can say that the salt can be separated from water by heating the solution. When we are heating, after some time water start boiling, and all the water will evaporate from the solution and salt will be left behind. Stirring with magnet. Students, how can we separate a mixture of sand and iron filings? Iron filings is a material, is a substance that can stick to the magnet, that have a property to stick to the magnet. So, a mixture of sand and iron filings can be separated by stirring the mixture with a magnet. Because of iron filing is a magnetic material, it quickly start sticking to the magnet. So the iron filling will stick and sand will be left behind. That is a way of separating this mixture of sand and iron filings. Now by filtration method. In the filtration method, we used to use this method, how that we just fix the filter paper on the funnel and just pour the mixture of sand and water to the funnel. So because of the filter paper, all the salt sand residue left on the filter paper and water will be drained off. So that is a way of that a filtering is a way to separate a solid from a liquid. And the water will pass through the filter paper, okay, but the sand will left on the filter paper. Now we are moving on to by adding water. So what happens to the adding water? For example, if you have a tissue paper, now you just put some drop of ink onto the tissue paper, and if you are just put the drop of water on the same place where you are putting the ink, you found that immediately once you drop the water, so you see that the ink will be start. Yes, they are start separating. Okay. And once you are just leave for the dry, you see that the different colors on that tissue paper. So the mixture of colored substances can be separated by adding water to it. By decantation. Students, an insoluble solid can be separated from a liquid by pouring of the clear liquid from the top of the mixture. This process is called decantation. The insoluble substance will remain at the bottom of the vessel. As you can see, it is a mixture of sand and water. After some time, you see that the layer of the sand comes to the bottom and water will be on the top. That is the process, that is a method called sedimentation, when water will be separated to the different pouring off on the different beaker. That is the process called decantation. Now we are moving on to the today's quiz. Students, are you ready? So this is a mixed form of unit number 4 and 5. So I hope that you already watched the video for unit number 4, and now we are on unit number 5. Before solving your Google Classroom quiz, please again and again watch the video and read the lesson thoroughly to attempt the quiz. It will help you to understand more. So students, fill the blanks to complete the statement. Air is a mixture of many gases. Fizzing contains sugar, flavoring water, and carbon dioxide gas. When sugar dissolves in water, we cannot see it. The sugar in a solution is called the solute. The surroundings of an animal or plant are called its environment. Tiny living things in the soil as bacteria and fungi are called decomposers. Animals that only eat other animals are called carnivores. Plants that grow in very hot places have thick, fleshy stems which can store water. So that will be all for today, students. I hope that you enjoy learning. Don't forget to wash your hands and don't forget your mask while you're going outside. Thank you, everyone.